Hello guys, my name is Ogie Bulim Steven. I'm a 400 level law student from the Faculty of Law, Nnamdi Azikiwe University, Awka, Anambra State. So today, I'll be talking to you guys about the topic, all you need to know about cross-examination. But for reference purposes, I would want to talk to you guys a little about what examination in chief means. So basically, the two terms, examination in chief and cross-examination, are related. And they definitely or basically involves all the process, an interrogation process, the question and answer process during a court proceeding, where a counsel asks a witness questions and expects the witness to give answers to the questions for the reason of establishing a certain facts or to adduce evidence. I don't know if you guys understand what I mean. But basically, to be specific, for examination in chief, it involves the counsel. A counsel is a lawyer representing either of the party to ask a witness for examination in chief, to ask a witness certain questions while he in turn expects answers. The reason why they do this is to either establish some facts or to adduce evidence from the answers the witness is giving. It is examination in chief when the counsel who is asking the question is the one that calls for the witness. So for instance, when as a plaintiff counsel, I call a witness for the plaintiff, the question and answer session I ask the witness I call upon is named as examination in chief. Then going to the other part, cross-examination, which is our point of discussion today. Cross-examination is where an opposing counsel involves the question and answer session, interrogates, more or less, let's use the word interrogation, asks a witness under oath certain questions, expecting certain answers or answers for the purpose of establishing facts or adducing evidence. That is what cross-examination is. To explain better, assuming I'm the counsel to the plaintiff and the counsel to the defense calls a witness to support their case, after the defense counsel conducts an examination in chief, it is now left for me to conduct a cross-examination. And the idea is to establish facts or to adduce evidence. Then explaining further, I want to make us understand certain key points. For cross-examination to happen or examination in chief to take place, such testimonies or such question and answer session, the witness has to be have sworn and oath to say the truth and nothing but the truth. And when you fail to say the truth under oath during a cross-examination session or an examination in chief session, you have committed an offense, a punishable offense known in law as perjury. It is a serious offense. And I don't need to tell you guys the rationale behind the reason why when you lie under oath, it's a punishable offense. I feel it's another topic we'll talk about another day. So having said that, a cross-examination session is actually very important for the side that is cross-examining the witness. The reason is being that it helps to either build or case. For instance, as a plaintiff counsel cross-examining a witness called upon by the defense, it is left for me to use cross-examination to either counter the evidence or facts being raised by the witness testifying under oath or to discredit such testimonies. So basically, when the counsel to defense calls up a witness that says, the client of A stole money, or the client of A did not keep my agreement, he has said something that he was there, this happened, he did not keep their agreement. This is what happens during examination where the defense counsel now asks, Oga, on so and so date, where are you here? He said yes. What happened? The plaintiff and the defense had an agreement. What happened after the agreement? And the plaintiff did not keep the agreement. That is examination. The defense counsel is trying to establish evidence by examining the chief, a witness he has called. Now it's left for me as a plaintiff lawyer to cross-examine. And what is expected of me to do is to ask questions, specific questions that will not only counter what the witness has said during examination in chief, but to discredit him as a witness. Things that would make the court understand that what this person is saying is actually not true. It has doubts, and as such, should not be seen as being an established evidence for the consumers. I don't know whether you guys want to get back to us through the question and answer channel if you can write it. Possibly, maybe you give you something before the level of student from the faculty floor, now that's being that's your car. Take care.